for having good anointed singers tonight. We got Joyful Praises, Ryan Smotherman, and Joyful Praises. And Highly Favored Three. So we're going to have a good time in the Lord. I tell you, we want to take some prayer requests. I know we got a lot to pray about. I know most everybody knows Brother Dale Bolton and his wife. It comes to the singing a lot. Brother Dale's mother-in-law, which is Tammy's mother, passed away a little while ago. So we need to remember that family in prayer tonight as we pray tonight. Anyone else got a prayer request tonight, Sister Rose?
Yeah, pray for my sister Kathy. She had surgery.
That's what your sister was telling.
We just need to ask brothers and sisters in the Lord to just join us and bring them to God, bring healing to their body, as you said, that the body's strength for healed.
That's right.
And also our friend, Pastor David Sparkman, he needs a little transplant. She was loved out of that, I think it was.
Okay. Let's remember those requests tonight. Anyone else tonight got a prayer request?
Won't y'all pray for this fellow right here? His name's Robbie Cotton, and he's on dialysis. And he lives in a nursing home. Y'all keep him in prayer.
Okay, yeah, let's do remember him in prayer. Anyone else tonight?
We have a friend of the family that the husband has passed away, so just keep the family in prayers.
Yes, remember that.
My best friend's daughter, John, she's in her 40s, early 40s.
She had a double mastectomy a couple weeks ago, and I was praying for that she does not have to have radiation, that they got everything on the other. Okay. It's a member of a good friend of mine, Pastor Danny Chance. He had brain surgery, and they found out that it was cancer, and he's taking radiation treatments. So they're making him real sick right now, so let's do remember him and his family and the church in prayer tonight. We got a lot to pray about, don't we?
Amen, that's it.
Anyone else tonight? All right, if you're able, let's all stand. We'll go to the Lord in prayer and pray God's blessings upon our service tonight. Brother Brian,
yes,
why don't you take us to the Lord in prayer, brother?
All right. Father God, we thank you for this day. Thank you for this evening, Lord, that we can come together as brothers and sisters in the Lord and worship you. First and most of all, Lord, and we know that if we worship you, you'll take away the sicknesses, Lord. And that's what we ask tonight, that you would hear our prayers, Lord, and that you would answer accordingly, Lord. We know your will to be done in all situations, Lord, whatever it may be. Lord, I ask that you would just forgive us where we fail you. Lord, that you would reignite fires tonight, Lord, within our hearts, Lord, and our souls. Lord, a burning desire to serve you more and more. Lord, that you would watch over each of us and keep us safe as we leave this place later. God, let us leave rejoicing that it had been a good time praising you. And Lord, I just pray and ask that you continue to bless this business, Lord, of Hardee's, as they've allowed this gospel music into this place, Lord. We ask that it would be a light in this community. And Lord, we'll give you the praise that you so deserve in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. I appreciate my good friend, Brother Brian Smotherman. And I tell you what, you're really going to get a blessing out of him. And we're going to let them enjoy for praise. I think they do some together and some separate, all this, that, and the other. But anyway, we're going to start out with them and let them take their liberty in the Lord. And we got Highly Favored Three that's going to be singing here in a little while. I tell you what, we just want to praise the Lord tonight. Feel like shouting, shout. Feel like running, run. Do you feel like
moving? And what are you trying
to do? You up,
and you're plugging me up. All right. He's getting me ready. But anyway, we appreciate Brother Brian and his family being here. It's been a while since I've seen all of y'all.
And I tell you what, it's always good to see a good friend.
Man,
that's right.
Glad to be your friend.
That's right. Glad to be your friend, too. But anyway, we appreciate that. So I tell you what, let's give them a great big hand. Brother Brian Smotherman and Joel.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Yeah, we can
do that. Amen. Well, good to be here for sure. It's good to be wanted and needed somewhere, isn't it? Amen. Listen to this old song here, Stand by the River. Road's been long, I'm a little bit weary, a lot of miles behind me, but home's a lot. lot dearer. Got one more crossing, it's a long way over. Why don't you stand by the river waiting for me? Why don't you stand by the river, Lord, and hold my trembling hand? Cradle me, sweet Jesus, from the cold, dark sea. Through the hills and the valleys, in the middle of the desert, you placed a fountain. Stand by me, Jesus, through the cold, deep water. Why don't you stand by the river, wait for me? Why don't you stand by the river, Lord, and hold my trembling hand? Cradle me, sweet Jesus, from the cold, dark, sinking sand. This is what never can take long. I'm kind of anxious to get on home, so stand by the river, wait for me. Why don't you stand by the river, Lord, and hold my trembling hand? Cradle me, sweet Jesus, from the cold, dark, sinking sand. This is one trip I can't take alone. I'm kind of anxious to get on home, so stand by the river, stand by the river, stand by the river, wait for me. Stand by the river, Lord. Stand by the river, wait for me. Why don't you stand by the river? Stand by the river. Stand by the river, wait for me. You excited to get home?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Brother Paul David, I'm the older I'm getting, the grumpier I get. I don't know. Y'all found that to be true? I don't know. I just we're getting right on like people. I got a shirt that said I used to be a people person, but people ruined it. I'm kidding. Oh my goodness. And sometimes you just don't want to go out in public no more, amen? Amen. This world is full of nuts anymore. I'm telling you, they are crazy, and I just don't want to be out in them. But I'm glad that I can come around and be with some good folk, amen? People that love the Lord, that's always a good thing. And but one thing's for sure, I've made preparations to go home one day. Well, everything's going to be glorious, amen? There ain't going to be old people up there either. There ain't going to be no aches and pains, no tears, no sorrows. Man, I'm excited about that place. And if you don't know, if you're going to that place, we'll talk to you tonight. Amen. Whether you're working here or just eating here or you can hear us outside this building, we need to make sure everything's right to go home one day, don't we? Amen. But anyway, let me do, I'm going to try another song here. I just done decided I'm going to try some new songs. So this is very new. I don't even remember the last time I practiced it. Other than right now, what I'm fixing to do. But that's the best thing. So it's a Jamie Johnson song. It's sort of a sad song, but I love this song that he does. And I hope that you'll get a blessing out of it because I've had it here in my iPad for a long time. My last tomorrow, I am holding to my last breath. Goodbye, sweet world, full of sorrow. Well, my new life begins with death. For I am standing on the mountain, Savior's song, and I am preaching over Jordan. Well, take my hand, Lord, lead me home.
Amen.
I like his second verse. All my burdens are behind me. I have prayed my final prayer. Well, don't you cry over my body. That ain't me lying there. Well, I am standing on the mountain. I can hear the angels' song, and I am reaching over Jordan. Take my hand, Lord, lead me home. And I am standing on the mountain. I can hear the angels song. And I am reaching over Jordan. Lord, lead me home. Take my hand. Lord, lead me home. What a song. Isn't that powerful? Woo, glory. I love that. I love the words of that song. He's got some good stuff. And but anyway, I want to do another one here. I don't know how, it's sort of a low track, brother, but I believe we got plenty of volume on it.
If not, we'll crank it up.
Pray for us.
I used to have some folks ask me to do this all the time. We used to do these Facebook Lives when COVID was happening, and it just seemed like everybody was doing Facebook Lives. And there's this one little old lady, she would always ask if I'd do this song. You can always find a steeple and a few religious people with the preacher on the front step shaking everybody's hand. Sign shaped like a Bible, a sense of a revival. Now there's a million dead churches just taking up an acre of land. Yeah. What we need is a soul filling station, a full service open 24 hours a day. I just popping that super salvation, yeah. We're a heart out of gas, can fill up for the past, get away, yeah, man. You can have the greatest choir, dress them up in long white robe attire, with the wall full of trophies showing off that softball team. Yeah. If the people aren't praying, that's how many's gonna be staying. Cause ain't nobody going up on no water down gasoline. Yeah. What we need is is the soul, fill and station. A full service open 24 hours a day. I just pumping that high octane super salvation. Yeah, I wear a hard out of mask and fill up for that fast getaway. What we need is a soul filling station. A full service open 24 hours a day. I just pumping that high. Super salvation. I wear a heart and a mask and fill up for that fast getaway. I wear a heart and a mask and fill up for that fast getaway. Singing about home, isn't it? It gets you fired up. I love singing about Jesus and heaven and all that good stuff. And but anyway, I'm going to do, I don't know how much time we've got between, I'll do three or four more. I won't give everybody plenty of time. All right, well, we'll do that.
Do at least seven more.
Do a seven. Woo, glory. All right, we can do that too. We're going to try it. All right. Well, thank you. I got one big fan over here. Well, speaking of heaven, this is probably one of my favorite hymnal songs that talks about heaven. There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day. Oh, what a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and he leads me through that promised land. Oh, what a day, glorious day. No more burdens to bear, no more sickness, no pain, and no more parting over there. And forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day. Aren't you thankful for that? Oh, what a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand shoulders and the arms of the glory. Thank you, Jesus. I like that.
Yes, sir.
I don't know if my... I'm going to see if this will pull up.
I'll say douche yard if you got it.
Douche, I don't have that one. I wish I did.
Hey, do you have three nails?
Three nails. I'm not with me. I don't have any with me. What you need a nail for? To nail it to the cross. So y'all do nail it to the cross. I've always picked on Paul David. I love him. I don't remember three crosses. You talking about Randy Travis?
Yeah.
Oh my. I don't know if it's, you say it's got one. Let's see if it's a... I may use
three wooden crosses, I think.
Three wood, yeah.
Three wooden crosses, yeah.
Let me see if I can find it, Brother Paul David. I just don't know if it's I'm gonna pick it up. It's not.
It's not.
It may be.
Your
sandwich
is in that
only
place.
Right in the corner.
Believe me, I know.
I should have
put it right in the corner.
Yeah. I don't think it's
going to
be on here.
Most of the time, though, we've learned too, like she told you. Sometimes you can't handle their mind right up there on the floor.
Especially if you're
electrified. It starts to, well, yeah. You got electricity in your body.
It's
electrified.
Right.
Yeah. But
I ain't finding it, Paul David. I am so sorry. Let me do this one right here. That's another bad habit. People used to do this one all the time. I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine, yeah. I could only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing with the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. When I'm surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah. I can only imagine. Thank you, Lord. I can only imagine. Yeah. I can only your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I before you, Jesus, for in all of you be still, will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall, will I sing hallelujah, will I be able to speak it all, I can only imagine, yeah, I can only imagine, thank you Jesus, I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. I can only imagine when all Brian will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. Thank you, Lord. What a beautiful song that is, too. Anybody watch the movie? Good stuff, buddy. Good stuff. And look what popped up. Hooker and a preacher, riding on a midnight bus, bound for Mexico. One was headed for vacation, one for higher education. Two of them were searching for lost souls. Well, that driver never ever saw the stop sign. And 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. For there are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That farmer left a harvest, a home and 80 acres, faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. And that teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children, did her best to give them all a better start. And that preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land? As he laid his blood-stained Bible in that hooker's hand. For there are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That's the story our preacher told last Sunday. As he laid that blood-stained Bible up in all of us to see, he said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher. He gave his Bible to my mama, who read it to me. For there are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, now I guess we know. No, it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Buddy, I got you there. You owe me on that. No. I ain't done that in a while.
That's right.
Well, thank you, brother. I like this one too. I'll just do it since it's up. Boy, that come on strong. Y'all wait. Y'all hear that? A train a coming. There's a long black train coming down the line, beating off the souls that are lost and crying. Rails of sin, only evil remains. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. Yeah, buddy. You can look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption staring back into your eyes. There is protection and there's peace the same. Burn in your ticket for that long black train. Cause there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father in the holy name. Don't go right. That long black train making you wonder if the ride is worth the pain. He's just waiting on your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory to the Father and His holy name. Don't go riding on that long black train. Yeah. They say, choo-choo. I wish I could play the harmonica. Hear the whistle from a mile away. It sounds so good, but I must stay away. That train is a beauty, making everybody stare. But its only destination is the middle of nowhere. Don't you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory. Devil's a driving that long black train.
Hey, Brian, you remember Eddie there, don't you?
Did you play guitar?
That's all you just got there saying. Yeah. That's his thing, John.
Well, no. Have you come in? Here, you want to sing? What you going to sing?
That's her song.
You going to sing with Mama?
You going to sing
with Mama? Or you going to sing that one song you sing with?
Jesus loves me.
You going to sing that one song you sing with? You going to sing with Mama? Yeah, Mama. Come up here and do your new song.
She wants to sing.
I'm going to have to get up and this.
Yeah.
let somebody else go too. Okay. We'll do this one more, all right? Which one you want to do? You want to do Greater Steve? You want to do Jesus Built This Church? Jesus Loves Me? Let's see if I got that. Okay. I bet I can find it.
Maybe he can find it. Maybe he can
find it. You just want to sing an acapella?
No.
No. I don't blame you.
You know what acapella means?
No. No. What about this little light of mine?
Yeah. I know.
Praise God for getting to be here. I'm glad that we're back in Alabama. And thank you, Paul David, for getting us back.
Yeah, I got a house.
Unless you're getting ready, we got Roger's guitar up here. Yeah, you.
You scared her.
We got her and Greg here, they can sing.
I'm heading home, how about y'all? Is this road your traveling dog, deserted or dear? Is there hope for tomorrow? Put your trust 14, you'll find out about riding white horses one of these days. God bless us with this song, and we praise Him for it. It's called Great White Horses, and it's on our newest album over there.
Praise. And then we'll ride those horses. those horses with Jesus by our side. Now will come the new Jerusalem. Old Satan's gonna be stripped of his pride. We'll walk down the streets of that city, dressed in a robe of pure white. And then we'll ride those horses with Jesus by our side. Great white horses, they'll be coming through the sky. Someday we'll ride those horses with Jesus by our side. Oh, Lord, with Jesus by our side. Oh,
y'all that don't know us, we're Joyful Praises from Smithville, Tennessee, and we're missing one. He's in Missouri right now. He works up there. He also has his own ministry. He accepted the call to preach a couple of years ago and got ordained last year, and he's out doing his stuff too, but he's coming back. He comes when he can, and this past Easter Sunday, for those that didn't get to see it on Facebook, he got on one knee and asked his girlfriend if he would marry, she would marry him, if he would marry her, and they both said yes. And of course, I said, and this mom will cry.
And she will cry.
And she will cry. For a week, or at least a week, but anyway, my baby.
And his daddy might
cry. His daddy did. But this song right here means a lot to me. When I first joined Joyful Praises, I found this song on a country CD. No, I didn't. On a country cassette. They wasn't CDs then. And actually, it was on a country album. It wasn't even a gospel album, but this song was on it, and I fell in love with it. But none of the guys in the band wanted to play it, so it stuck in my CD, in my cassette player, in my cassette box for a long time. After Roger and I got married, we were going through. He said, "Well, what is that song?" And I played it. He says, "How come y'all never done that?" I said, "The band didn't want to." So he said, "We're doing it." But I'm going to do this one for Paul David. He likes this. And this is my testimony and always has been. It's called Hit the Road. This is why I do what I do. Part of it.
Shores of Galilee.
Talking
lights. We're getting ready for one more night. I'd never walk on a stage if it wasn't for you. Can't do it without you, Jesus. 'Cause you left heaven. Hit the road and the shores of Galilee. You gave yourself at Calvary. So I'm gonna go and tell them what you've done for me. But you to me. You know, we never know about a person. They put on this facade, this happy face all the time, and you think that everything's all right, but you don't see behind the curtain of their life. Every one of us live in a separate home. Of course, you know, me and Roger live in the same, but you know what I mean. And even in our own home, we don't see behind our curtain. I don't see behind his curtain. He can't see. And I don't even know why I'm saying all this, but I'm saying it anyway because evidently meant to. We don't see behind each other's curtains. I don't see behind Georgiana's. Although I know and I believe in my heart she's blood bought born again, only her and Jesus know for sure. And one day over in Jasper, Tennessee, one night exactly, we were ministering and singing and just pouring our hearts out. And this young lady was sitting in the back of the church, being in every singing that Joyful Praises that I know of been to, and even some, you know, even more than that. And I thought she was born again. And she come running to the altar that night. And I thought she's just having a hard day. You know, just come pray with me. I need little strength. Christians, strong Christians need strength. Our brothers and sisters need strength sometimes. Because life is hard. But you know, so I also learned that even though it says we're to carry each other's burdens, but like Brother Ronnie said the other night in Sunday church, he said, we got to carry our own backpack. That burden means a devastating thing. If you read it in commentaries and stuff in the Hebrew and the Greek, that word carries each other's burden doesn't mean just having a hard day and you just help them get through it. That just helps them to get along doing you doing it for them. But that burden you carry for somebody else is a devastating thing in their life that you help them carry. But just everyday stuff, we're supposed to carry ourselves. We're not supposed to enable anybody to get through stuff on, you know, that they can get through on their own, I guess is what I'm trying to say. But that night, Miss Talisha came to the altar that night, and like I said, I thought she just wanted strength. And she said, I need to get saved. I thought I was saved all these years, but I really want to get saved tonight. And she got up from there praising God and declaring beyond a doubt that God wrote her name in the Lamb's Book of Life. And I praise God for you, Talisha. And I've used you a few times when God leads me to do that. Because you never know what somebody's going through. You never know. Because we do. We put on a good, happy face. We get behind the scenes and cry our eyes out. And our hearts are broken.
Well, I guess that's why I was supposed to sing a song.
That's right.
She didn't know what I was going to be.
Yeah. If you're bound up tonight, I don't know. I know many times God takes the voices and the music and the words, and He carries it everywhere He wants it to go, into the deepest corners that you wouldn't think somebody's standing there listening. But I pray that if you're bound up and burdened tonight, if you need saving, that's what we're here for. We'll introduce you to Jesus. But if you just need strength, you come and we'll help you, because you can go free for sure.
Thank God he broke all thy chains that I and you can still go free. Oh, that I could still go free. Somebody tell me what kind of man would reach down his hand and he would do this for me. Oh, so unworthy to live and not fit to kill. Then a man on the cross, he put me in his will, and he said that I could still go free.
We're gonna do two more. We're going to do a couple more. I'm so glad that because Jesus loved me enough, he looks beyond all my faults, all my failures, all my mess ups, into the real me, who he wants me to be. He looks beyond my faults. And he loves each and every one of you. We're not perfect. We're not going to be on this side of glory. But we can strive to be perfect like he is. Amazing grace will always be my song of praise. For it was grace that brought my liberty. I do not know just why he came to love me so. He looked beyond my fault and he saw my need. I shall forever.
To view the cross where
cross is where it started, where it can end for you. All you gotta do is nail it down. Let Jesus have it.
Is there something in you above, between you and the Lord? Are you drifting apart, not as close anymore? There's nothing you can do that He will not forgive. Bring it to the cross and let it die so you can live. Nail it to the cross, get it under the blood. Drown your pain and every stain in the mercy flood. Nail it to the cross and hope and forgiveness. Kneel at the tree, walk away free. Kneel it to the cross. Is there a burden you bear that's got you battered and bound, struggling for strength? Do you long to lay it down? Don't take another step. Just kneel where you stand. Lay it on the cross and take the hammer in your hand. Nail it to the cross. Get it under the blood. Drown your pain. Nail it to the cross. Find hope and forgiveness. Kneel at the tree, walk away free. Nail it to the cross. Nail it to the cross. Get it under the blood. Drown your pain in every stain in the mercy flood. Hope and forgiveness. Kneel at the tree, walk away free. Nail it to the cross. Nail it to the cross. Find hope and forgiveness. Kneel at the tree, walk away free. Nail it to the cross. Nail it to the cross.
Thank you.
see with Jesus, the disciples were getting concerned. The wind started violently blowing, but he was asleep in the stern. Does he not care that we perish? We're helpless and we're so afraid. Jesus arose when they called him and said to them, where is your faith? He called you great, oh God. Called you held on with all of your might. Child, your cry have woken the Master. Oh, lift your hands, it's time to rejoice. Child, your cry has awoken the Master.
Aren't you thankful for that today that he knows your voice?
Cause it hit you without any warning. The storm of your life has begun. But seeing no hope in the distance, you're frightened and nowhere to run. By now your vessel is filling, you're thinking that you're surely drowned. You've cried out for help from the Savior, and you know you can't give up now, because you pray. Held on with all of your might. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Oh, he knows your voice. Lift your hands, it's time to rejoice. Child, your cries have awoken.
You're up there worried, yeah. He's fast asleep.
Yeah.
The winds are so deadly, the water's so deep. But try to be patient, cause soon he'll bring peace. Yeah. Just one word from his voice, it all must cease. Because you prayed all night, cause you held on with all of your might.
The troubles and trials that we face, man, if I didn't have somebody going with me, this man called Jesus.
That's right.
Woo, glory.
Yeah. Ain't that the wrong sweet spirit?
Amen. Yes, sir.
All right, I tell you what.
All right, y'all enjoy Brother Brian Smotherman and the joyful praise.
All right, we appreciate highly favored three, Sister Rose and them. And I tell you, well, I still call you highly favored three.
That's right.
The Holy Spirit, right? Anyway, y'all come ahead, and then after they get through, we're going to get Miss Talisha up here to sing. We got a guitar up here. This brother that comes around, yes, sometimes. He's going to sing church for us.
And Sheila's not going to let you rest until you do that song just for laughing. So I tell you what, we're going to let him do that here in a little while. And then we'll get Joyful Praise and Brian Smothers to come up here and do something together. All righty. We appreciate Holly Favor 3. All right. Well, we don't have Midnight Cry. Midnight Cry. Ain't that right, Rob? The Midnight Cry. That's right. Well, all righty, I tell you, we appreciate them coming all the way from Rome, Georgia to be here tonight. And I tell you, we love them, appreciate them very much. Let's give them a great big hand. Holly Favor 3.
Well, I sure haven't turned off singing tonight. Anybody else? All right. Now give Jesus a big hand, will you?
Yeah.
He's awesome. He's an awesome God. He's helping us. He's talking about the storms and stuff that we all go through and how we all live in southern homes. And our pastor talked about, you know, coming to church here with him and that, with the iron mask, you know, and so on and such. And, you know, we can all come in and say, you know, every time somebody else behind you says, oh, I'm blessed, I can't complain. Yeah, right. You know, all knowing I got all kinds of junk going on in my life and I need more of Jesus every day, every hour.
Y'all remember them, don't you?
Exactly. How could they help it? He's our music man at the church.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. He was, wasn't he?
We never knew his name until the night we always started our music man.
The music man, that's right.
Well, the three sins of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, because that's who we represent. There are three of us, but that's not what that stands for. The Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
I wrote
it. Oh, well.
I'm
high time. Oh, it's all good. I remember you from one of the churches too, but yesterday, I can't remember where, but I seen you were one of the singing somewhere along the line. So you walked through the door like, side door that, man.
Okay, this one. Check.
I was.
You think
I have
the
volume?
Check.
Mm-hmm. And you're right in front of them.
Start back. Let me just put them all first before we even start.
Stand for the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
crazy decisions in our lives, and thank God for the blood that applied, which is that we can nail it to the cross tonight. And then I thank God that everything that I've ever done and said and done is gone. Yeah, right. And to see your forgetfulness, that God has been so good to me in my life, I can't even complain.
Amen.
He's been really, really, really good to me. He's healed my body from sicknesses, delivered me from alcohol and nicotine and all kinds of crazy stuff. So, good God.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Save us.
in all his kingdom would never pay the ransom price. The cost that Jesus paid with his life. Listen now. Grace is not what I with a great eternal question. There's a knock upon your heart's door. It calls to enter in. Swing wide the door and bid him welcome. The hold of sin will surely break. One touch of God's grace, a soul is so
so foolish and so blind. And by myself I cannot make it. I need your help divine. Lord, if you'll just do it, please touch me once more time. I know.
Coming and I can't hold it like, oh. So Sometimes it's just hard to contain yourself.
Where are you from?
Huh?
Where are you from?
New Jersey.
My mom, that's what I thought.
Yep. Her
mom.
I'm from your mama.
I said you're from your mama.
I'm in the lineage of Jesus. I don't know where you're at.
Oh, you nobody else knows Jesus. I know.
All right. We're going to try to attempt to sing this. Y'all pray for us. No matter what we go through and how hard life is, no! We know it's your life. Well,
I don't know why it's like that.
That's weird, isn't it?
week.
I know, I love it. I love it.
Y'all enjoy a highly favored lottery. That's right. You're right. If we care, if they ain't gonna hear me sing there.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. We love you, love.
Just let me say this. When I was a little girl, I was in school when they had the Glee Club. Y'all remember Glee Club?
Oh, Glee Club, yeah.
I tried to go over there and sing for them folks. And that lady, she said, well, come in here and I'll tell you. You see where you're at and what key you're in, where, blah, blah, blah. When I got down on that shit, she said, honey, you need to go into the house. You can't carry two in a bucket. You just had a handle on it. I was devastated. I was. So anyway, that's all right. I'm still carrying it for Jesus.
Well, that's right. That's right. That's amazing. They would carry me off. All right. We appreciate the Cottdeals being here tonight. And that means Sister Talisha and Brother Greg Caldwell is coming up front to sing. Well, you can stand up here with her anyway. Now, I know Brother Greg can sing because I've heard it. But anyway, we're going to let them sing. Then after they get through, we're going to let this brother right here. I can't ever remember your name. Dan, that's right.
Dan the man.
Yeah, Brother Dan. I remember them were over there at Raphael's there. So
yeah,
we're going to let him do a couple for us, and then we'll turn to Joyful Praises and Brian Leatherman, and Sheila's coming to her daddy. So we're going to let Eddie sing that song.
Eddie Sean, take your
hand
out,
he'll sing
it.
Well, now you heard that, didn't you, Sheila Roger?
I said, oh, Lord, is he?
Me too. All right. All right, come on up, Brother Greg. He don't like you tonight. Talisha, does he not like you tonight?
I don't think so. How many months, Greg?
Well, y'all said 4 months.
I'm sorry.
6 months. Is it 6 months, Greg? 6 months. All right. All right, we appreciate Sister Talisha. And we appreciate her. And then after she gets through, we're going to let Brother Dan sing. And then we're going to turn Brother Eddie and Sister Sheila and Joyful Praise and Brian Smith back loose. All right, let's give Sister Talisha Caldwell a great big hand to sing.
All right.
So Greg likes to sing with the kids at church. But he won't sing with his wife.
No.
Oh, okay.
He still loves you, Talisha. I hope he knows his puppet. He's a sick kid. Yep.
Except
when the kids sang.
6 months, Greg.
Not Greg. Right. I didn't come prepared to sing.
Yeah,
it's hard.
You got this, girl.
It's a long. Keep
Is that something, what are you going to do?
Sheila was talking earlier about the not production. Came to Jesus. It'll be 3 years, November 1st.
All right. I'll never forget that night. Because when she come running to the altar, I thought, bless her heart. And Eric, somebody come up to Eric and said, Talisha said she wants to get saved. And I thought, what? She told me she was saved, but, you know.
I believe Eddie, you was there that night, wouldn't you?
No, he wasn't there that night. Okay. No, he wasn't there that night.
It'll be 3 years.
It's
almost 3 years.
That's all right. She came up off that altar and she said, I'm new.
Yes.
I
remember Eric was there.
Yeah.
Thank you.
My brother said, John, from Saudi days in that, play music up there. Some of these people had seen it.
Come on, or something.
What?
Doesn't sure. Something.
Sounds like a beer. Yeah, just need to get closer. But normally people up there, I play banjo and that, so people know me. No, from that area know me as that. We'll play guitar tonight, so be good with that. This is an old Jimmy Fortune song here. When I see the sun rise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face, when I hear the sound of children playing, I know it's a part of God's amazing grace. I believe there's a place called heaven, and I believe in a place called Calvary. Though I believe in a man whose name is Jesus, and I believe that he gave the other day my mom went to heaven. I held her hand as she closed her eyes to sleep. I felt the power of the thousand angels make her so afraid to be crowned as they. Ever know with something traumatic like that. I thought, wonderful
still be able to play. I wonder if we might be able to sing or remember the words in the songs or not. Didn't make it. They actually let me out of the hospital before I had a chance to bring it to me. But first thing I did when I got back to a friend of mine, I'm staying out, I said, picked up my banjo. Well, sang Amazing Grace. Fingers all still work. I wish I could say that, oh yeah, I remember the words of the song a whole lot better than I did before, but I still know. But this is a song, this is my testimony song. It's called In the Time That You Gave Me. You know, the Lord left me on this earth to still do something. He could have taken me away. So I get out and I go sing. If somebody says they're piano player isn't going to be there, they need somebody to lead choir, I go all over. I probably average singing somewhere probably between 5 and 6 times a week. But the other day, I heard about a month or so ago, I asked the Lord, I said, I need to slow down a little bit. This is getting a little bit too much. That didn't work. So for about 3 weeks, 3 or 4 weeks straight out, I was between seven and eight different services a week. But this is my song. Just listen to the words of this song. I don't claim to be much of a singer, much of a musician, but I do what the Lord tells me to do the best I can.
Amen.
Treat tonight. Brother Eddie Kirk and Sister Sheila Gall is going to sing a song tonight, and we're looking forward to that. And then Joyful Praise and Brian Smothern are going to close it out as they see fit too. And we appreciate all of them. Y'all enjoy Highly Favored 3. I tell you what, they done a great job. And I tell you, we always enjoy Joyful Praises and and Brian Smotherman. Right. We always enjoy you. You're welcome. And I tell you what, we appreciate them very, very much. All righty. Is this the Golf family or is this the Kirk family? But we're gonna turn them loose, whoever they are.
Check one.
Not away we are now. All right.
If it gets hard.
Oh, no.
Man, it's good to be here tonight. I didn't come prepared to this. Man, I've been doing some gardening and my sinuses are a mess. But I couldn't turn Sheila and Roger down. They're faithful to me.
Turn him up.
I'm gonna try. I hope I can remember the word Shield's got on here, but been a while since I've sung this song.
Joyful noise is all we said.
She'll keep it going, so that's what we're trying to
do. There's a picture on the wall that brings me comfort. Weary eyes rest on it. There's a picture.
You know, people think that Jesus is this awesome. Now, don't get me wrong. God is God and we ain't. And he's a serious God. But he has a sense of humor. All of us, all we got to do is look in the mirror to see that God's got a sense of humor. He's made each and every one of us unique. And that's what it talks about. He's, you know, there's a sweet, unique depiction of the Savior. Jesus is us, all wrapped up in one. So think about that as we do this.
There's a picture on the wall that brings me comfort. Weary eyes rest on it. It's a sweet. There's a picture on the wall that brings me comfort. Weary eyes rest on the ground. It's a sweet day to be of the Savior. The only one I know what I love is God. It shows him my faith. Our Lord is my faith. His head from back we go and on his loving face. And in that moment, your son
One Saturday night, we were there, and I don't know how y'all believe, if you believe in angels, I believe in Jesus Christ, and I know there are angels because they've helped me. My guardian angel, the Lord dispatched him on May 19, 1973 at 4:32 in the morning when my dad flipped a semi-truck over, the right front tire blew out, exploded the diesel tank. I went through the windshield. I was on fire. Had hair down to here. The only thing that saved my face from being burned more than it cut, more than it was. Had 150 stitches in my head, two holes in the back of my head, lost almost 4 pints of blood. Almost had to go to the burn center, and Children's Burn Center in Birmingham, Alabama, but God dispatched my guardian angel as a Ross Neely truck driver to help my daddy get me up off that burning motor and save my life. I got saved at 11 years old that June of 1969 and 73, the devil tried to kill me. The moment you give your heart and life to the Lord, you're on the devil's hit list. Don't let that stop you from serving God. Don't let that stop you from letting Him write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life, because that's the only way to get to heaven, to stay. Everybody's going to heaven, but everybody ain't staying. But the reason I know that Ross Neely truck driver was my guardian angel manifest was the fact that we searched everywhere for that Ross Neely truck driver and could not find him. And many, many years later, I was doing my Bible study, and I said, I'm going to call Unsolved Mysteries and have them help me find the guy, the Ross Neely truck driver, that helped my daddy get me out of that burning truck. And in my spirit, I heard God say, you'll never find him, because that was your guardian angel. Wow. I will see that angel one of these days. Angels are not little old women dressed up pretty dresses. Angels are men of war. Ooh, that makes the hair stand up on my head. I'm so glad for the angel that God gives us, but I praise God for the Son of God, Jesus Christ on my head.
This is for Brother Paul and whoever else likes this song. I love this song myself. Wait a minute.
I didn't have the music ready.
This song talks about 11:59. I think that time's coming pretty quick with you, the way this whole world's going. So listen to the words of it. Our son usually does this song, but he's not with us tonight, and sometimes I pick it up when he's not with us. So we're going to try this one for you tonight, 11:59.
Thank you.
evil's breaking loose on every side. Now the devil knows it's time, it's almost over. And soon the clock will stop, and Jesus Christ will split the sky. So shout it from the rooftop, proclaim it in the street. Go and tell your friends and neighbors, tell everyone you meet. Now we all need a Savior, but we're running out of time. He's coming back at midnight, and it's 11:59. I like this verse. God's prepared a place for all his children. Now it's free from fear and doubt and tears and pain. Oh, church, tonight we must choose our destination. 'Cause there's just one way to heaven, and Jesus is his name. So shout it from the rooftop, proclaim it in the streets. Go and tell your friends and neighbors, tell everyone you meet. Oh, that we all need a Savior, but we're running out of time. He's coming back at midnight. It's 11:59. Listen, church.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
At the right hand of the Father, he'll soon stand to his feet. He'll say, son, go get my children and bring them home to me. So shout it from the rooftop, proclaim it in the streets. Go and tell your friends and neighbors, tell everyone you meet. Oh, that we all need this Jesus, but we're running out of time. He's coming back at midnight, and it's 11:59.
Bill Gaither's trios put this song out originally, and Brian and Rex rewrote the music.
Remember this?
Yes, I do.
And we fell in love with it, and Brian and them said, "Well, it ain't my song, but they let us use that music, and I love this." And so we're gonna do this one for you. He came down to my level.
Oh, yeah.
This is actually Rex playing on this track. We recorded it in a little garage.
If you're looking for contentment in the things that you can see, you're gonna have some disappointments. So won't you listen to me, please? 'Cause I know about a Savior. He came down to be a man, and when he left, he sent his Spirit. He made me everything I am. When he came down to my level,
with a strong arm, he lifted me up to show me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came.
Sometimes I've made decisions that later I regret, but the Lord keeps on assuring me he's not finished with me yet. I don't worry about tomorrow, I don't worry about yesterday, I don't worry about sort of said, I'm through with you. I don't want to have nothing to do with God. Nothing ever goes right. I'm tired of it. We all get in that place. But you know what? We don't have to stay there. I'm glad he's looks beyond my faults and takes me back. I'm glad he don't throw the clay away. That he picks us up and carries us on.
Brother Paul David wanted me to do this earlier, so.
I thought y'all were leaving me.
I'm kidding. This is a great song. Brother Paul David said I used to sing it with some nails in my hand and hit it together. I vaguely remember that. You know, I'm getting older. That's probably been 15 years ago or better.
Maybe close to 20 years.
Probably 20 years when we had a singing out in his front yard, and I don't know if any of y'all, was anybody there? Was anybody born yet? Hey, Eddie was there. Okay, that's probably the last time we've seen each other then. But you know, this song is simply entitled "Feel the Nails." I think it was an old Ray Bogus song, and you know. Going about Ray Bogus right now, but you know it's amazing how God gives such anointed songs to folks and they turn from God. He's one of them. Mike Bolan, I love Mike Bolan stuff, and they just turn an eye away from God. I just don't understand it. To be so anointed. But you know what? I'll pick these songs up and I'll keep singing them. Amen. I'll let the anointing fall. And so this song is so powerful. And I wish you'd listen to the words. It's called Feel the Nails. Because, folks, I'm here to tell you, you know, Jesus has paid it all.
Amen.
All to Him I owe. Amen. He's done everything. We've talked about His grace tonight. You know, I'm thankful that we all have His grace. And we can receive it. But if that grace is not activated through your faith in Him, amen, you ain't got nothing but just a story.
That's true.
Amen. A message of Jesus' saving grace is just useless if the faith is not activated. Because we're saved by His grace through our faith. Amen. It says that our faith will catch sight one of these days. When we talk about singing and seeing Jesus, our faith is going to get us that. It's what He done on an old rugged cross and shed that blood for us. But folks, if we've never received it, you know what? I mean, it's... But once we have received it, and you know, I think about this a lot of times, Brother Paul David, that when we mess up, you know, the church today is in a place where they feel comfortable in that grace. Well, I'm just gonna sin anyway. I mean, I'm thankful that that's what their mentality is. I'm just a sinner, saved by grace. Is it not? I mean, you hear it all the time. I'm just an old sinner. Well, if you go around calling yourself just an old sinner, that's what you're going to be.
That's right.
But I'm a child that's belonging to God now. I'm a born-again believer.
Yes.
And we're supposed to do away with that stuff. We're supposed to do away with our old life. And when it rears its ugly face, we need to crucify it again. And you know that by our actions, the Word of God tells us that we can crucify the Son all
that's
over
right.
again.
Yeah.
God forgive us. Because I don't want Jesus to feel any other nail. He paid it all. And folks, by our actions, we can deny the Son of God. So listen to the words of this song, Feel the Nails.